to present Henrik's Hall of Fame plaque once again, Brian Burke.
Thank you, Brian. As you might know, I've just recovered from COVID. It came down to a last-minute decision to attend, but as our coach has always said, Henrik at 70% is a lot better than Daniel at 100. Thank you to Mike Gartner and the selection committee for this tremendous honor, and to Chairman Lanny McDonald and the Hockey Hall of Fame staff for organizing this weekend's events. I started playing hockey when I was 6 years old. I skated a lap, realized that skating was not easy. I retired for a year and came out of retirement at 7. As kids, Daniel and I were always on the same team, but played on different lines, both as centers. We got moved up to older teams when we were 12, and Daniel moved to the wing. From then on, until we turned 24, we were always on the same line and also the youngest players on every team. Because we were always the youngest, we never felt that anything was given to us and that we had to work to earn everything. That really helped us throughout our careers. To have the feeling at 23 of not belonging in the NHL, to be standing here now and be part of this evening, along with Daniel, Herb, Lou, Rika, and Daniel, shows what an unbelievable journey it's been. There are so many people to mention. Mike Barnett, JP Berry, Klaus Elefalk, thanks for everything you've done for me. You always respected my wishes, even when we asked to stay in Sweden one more year after the draft. Thomas Gredin, you were the one who pushed hard to draft us, and I'm glad to still call you a friend. Brian Burke, without you, I don't think we would have played in Vancouver for our entire careers. You drafted us, you protected us the first couple of years when people wanted you to trade us, and you believed in us from day one. I'm happy that we were able to show that you were somewhat right. My first head coach in the NHL was Mark Crawford. Thanks, Mark, for your guidance in the early days of my career. You pushed me every day, and you made me understand what it took to become a professional, to show up every night and compete. I haven't talked enough of what you meant to my career, but I can promise you that when I talk with people how young players should come into this league today and be taught what it takes to win, you are the example. Elaine Vigneault, you believed in us and drove us to get from good players to players that could lead every night. It took a while, and you had some hard and honest meetings with us that created a player-coach bond that was great to be part of. You coached the way the game is supposed to be coached, and it was easy for us to buy in and lead in our own way. I also want to mention Rick Bowness, who played a big part in the success of those teams, and Newell Brown, who taught us almost everything we know about the power play. I really appreciated all the power play discussions we had over a cup of coffee in your office, Newell. 18 years means a lot of line mates and teammates. Trent Klatt, I know you sacrificed a couple of good years in your career to teach two young Swedes how to play in North America. Thank you. Alex Burrows, I'm not sure how we managed to have the success we had. You spoke French, we communicated like dolphins. But every time we stepped over those boards, we knew we could make a difference. I'm happy to see you coach with the same passion and drive you had back when you played. Trevor Linden, as a teammate, you took hits both on the ice and with media for us. You were our biggest supporter, and I'm forever thankful for that. To Kevin Bieksa, Ryan Kessler, Alex Sedler, and Yannick Hansen, you guys came up a couple of years after us. Thanks for helping create a culture where results were just a byproduct of our everyday process. Roberto, you were the face of that culture. I've never been around anyone with the same determination and willingness to do anything to get better. It's an honor to be here tonight with you. When I was named the Canucks captain in 2010, I spent 7 years learning from a role model whose early career was similar to mine in many ways, Marcus Näslund. Marcus, Thank you not only for your friendship back to the days in Övik, but also for showing me how to lead, both when things were going well, but more importantly, when things were going badly. Mom and Dad, with everything you did for us growing up, I think the most important thing was that you let us be kids. We never went to hockey or soccer camps in the summer. We were never pushed to pick a sport until we had to. I believe that's one of the main reasons why we kept the passion for the game our whole career. To Peter and Stefan, when your friends came over for a game of soccer or street hockey, you always had two younger brothers asking to join. Thanks for letting us, even though I'm guessing it wasn't always fun. I'm fortunate to have played my entire NHL career with one team. Although faces have changed, the strong friendship and support from the Canucks organization, ownership, front office, staff remain the same. Many of you are our closest friends today. Thanks also to the NHL and the NHLPA, who continue to ensure that the game of hockey they represent continues to grow and evolve. Events like this make you stop and think about all the games and cities you played in around the world, the people you met and friendships you made along the way. From those who have known me since I was a kid in Örnsköldsvik to those who met through our kids and life in Vancouver, sincerely, thank you. Johanna, the most important person last. I know you don't like this attention. I don't look at myself as selfish, but looking back at the last 15, 20 years, I've been kind of selfish. You're the one that had to deal with the 6 a.m. hockey practices, the evening soccer games in pouring rain, many nights dealing with sick kids, and never questioning me leaving early every morning all summer so I can get my training in. Through all this, you raised two very kind and thoughtful boys. Walter and Harry, whatever life brings you, never change who you are. I didn't forget about you, Daniel. Apart from your on-ice greatness, the thing that made me get to where I am standing here tonight is what you did off the ice. To know that someone would be in the gym every morning waiting for me on the days I felt like taking a day off. That's what made me the player I was. When people ask where confidence comes from, that's where it came from, our preparation. Finally, because Daniel's not speaking after me, to end the debate, who the better player was, I missed 30 games in my career, and Daniel's production was not the same. In 2010, Daniel missed 20 games for concussion. I had 11 goals and 9 assists. So with Daniel, I was barely a 20-goal scorer. Without him, I would have been a career 45-goal scorer. Thank you so much for this tremendous honor. Thank you.